another Tamariki Ma. Welcome back to another Kiwi Can Online episode. Our greeting TALOFA lover coming to you all the way from Samoa, which is a country in the Pacific Islands. Samoa is made up of two main islands, which are called Upolu and Sava'i, and they have 188,000 people that live there. Taro is their favourite food, and their favourite sport is a game called kilikiti. Now, kilikiti is pretty much Samoa's version of cricket. Also, two of your Kiwi Can leaders, Matuatiri and Dan, both have Samoan heritage. Remember, our kaupapa, our theme during these episodes is resilience, or taikaha, which means coping with challenges and bouncing back. If we come up against something that is challenging for us, we make sure we never give up and we always try our best, no matter how hard that challenge may be. Alright, in today's episode, we're going to be talking about how we can keep ourselves healthy and relaxed, plus we're also going to have a lot of fun with some arts and crafts. So, we might as well just get straight into it, but before we do, kiwi, kiwi, kiwi! Nice tamariki ma. Now let's go and have a lot of fun with all of our Kiwi Can leaders.
Man, I've been doing this for about 10 minutes. I still can't get it. Just keep going, just keep going. I need a break.
TALOFA lover everyone, we understand that this may be a challenging time for us or during this rāhui, but we have to be resilient and find ways we can deal with our challenges. And today I've decided to pick up a drawing book to help me cope with my challenges. Be resilient and concentrate on staying within the lines. If you make a mistake, that's okay. Pick up your pen and try again. And remember, it's not a race. You get to take your time. Don't be shy to use as much colours as you like.
Alright, let's do this! And there you have it, a completed cube. Remember that it's okay to take a break from your challenges. Find something fun, and then go back and be resilient and try and finish what you started. Thank you all for joining in today. I hope you enjoyed. And remember, stay safe and be resilient. Ka kite.
TALOFA lover everyone!
I hope you're having an awesome day today and with our activities, and I hope you're ready to do my one. My health activity for today is called I Can. So I Can is going to be something you can use for when you're feeling sad or a bit down, to help you uplift yourself to be happy and feeling super energetic and awesome, right? So I'm going to show you what I Can is in just a few seconds. So the first I Can is you're going to tell yourself, I can breathe in and breathe out when counting to five. So should we give this a go? Let's give it a go. Guys, we're gonna say I can, but we're gonna say I can give myself a nice, awesome hug. Okay, should we give that a go?
Cool.
And you can hold it for 10 seconds long if you want. For our next one is the I can. This one is, I can pretend to blow out candles and sniff flowers. So I'll show you guys how this one goes, okay? So we're gonna give this a go, guys. So you're gonna breathe in through your nose like you're sniffing flowers. And blow like you're blowing candles, okay? Try again, breathe in. Like that, one more time.
Cool.
Our last I can, guys, what you're gonna do is you're gonna say, I can sing my favorite song, okay? So what you're gonna do is you're gonna sing your favorite song. I'm gonna sing you mine right about now.
It's a little bit funny, this feeling inside.
For that last one, guys, you don't need a piano or anything. If you have a cool song that comes to your mind that is your favorite song that you think can calm you down, do sing it to yourself. You don't need anything, just your awesome voice. So guys, that's the end of our activity for today. I hope you guys enjoyed it. But remember, if you are feeling a bit down or feeling a bit sad, remember that you can use the I can to help you guys uplift yourself and feel a bit better. Hope you guys enjoyed our activity, and let's get to the next one.
TALOFA lava and welcome back to Kiwi Can. Today we're going to learn how to solve our problems through meditation. Meditation is a simple exercise that we can do every day, anytime, at any place. I'm going to show you an example of how we can use it.
I can't do it.
Sometimes we might feel like we can't do something, but it might be because we're a little frustrated, which means we need to take some time out to breathe. Alright guys, so I have a simple exercise that I want you to do. I want you to breathe in for 4 seconds and then breathe out.
You gotta breathe in.
Yeah. Alright, so we're gonna show you how to do it together. Ready? Follow along with us. Okay, let's do some breathing. Ready and breathe in.
Breathe out.
Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Are you breathing in and out? Are you breathing in and out?
Nee.
Should we try that again?
Nee.
Breathe in. Breathe out. So that's a simple exercise that you can do if you're feeling a little bit angry, or maybe you're feeling like you can't do something. Take a simple deep breath and then try and do it again. Thank you guys for watching, and we'll see you soon.
TALOFA.
TALOFA everybody, Mato Terry here with a little bit of science for you. Alright, so in these times we have heaps of germs and that's how we're getting sick. So I want you to show you something really cool. Okay, so these Q-tips, they're going to be my fingers. Here we have some pepper, these are going to be the germs. Alright, and I have some soap here. Alright, we'll squeeze it in here, you'll see it. And we put some water into this little container, so you can see there's heaps of water in there and there's germs everywhere. Okay, and what happens is we put some germs in here, so the pepper, you can see the dark color, that is pepper, that is our germs. All right so we'll squeeze the soap in here, so you can see it's soap. All right and your finger goes in, and all the germs are in there, and it goes in there, your fingers are there, and it sticks. You can see, you can't really see, but you can see there's some little black things on there, that's germs. Alright, but if we turn it over, and wash our hands with the soap, keep our hands clean, alright, and put it back where the germs are, and the germs start running away. That's why we have to keep our hands clean. Alright, helps us be safe, helps everyone else in our bubble be safe, and it means that we're showing respect to each other. Okay? So give it a try at home, you might enjoy learning something new. Take care, be safe, see you soon. Peace!
Awesome work, tamariki mā. Hopefully, we learned a lot about keeping ourselves nice and healthy during these times. Alright, before we say our catchphrase and get into some arts and crafts, it's time for a laser clap. And the laser clap we're going to do today is called a Matua Bruce clap. Now, Matua Bruce is a very close friend of Kiwi Can, and he created this laser clip especially for Kiwi Can. Okay, so Matua Bruce clip goes like this. Thank you so much for creating that laser clip for Kiwi Can. Matua Bruce, muchly appreciated. Alright, let's quickly say our catchphrase and then have lots of fun with some arts and crafts.
Staying home is the best. We get to eat, play and rest. By staying inside our bubble, we keep our family out of trouble.
What's up everyone? Today is all about making masks. And if you're a bit like some of us here, we don't have all the arts and crafts stuff to make a mask, then that's all right. I'm gonna help you use the different things around your house to make a mask. Let's go. Mask for today, okay? And so if you have a hoodie like me, all you need to do is put your hoodie on, boom, put your hoodie on, put your mask in the middle. And there we have it. There we have it, y'all. Protect yourself. And don't get fogged up by your diesel. Let's go. And if you are wanting to be a bit extra when it comes to your lid mask, then grab yourself a felt. I've got myself a whiteboard marker and start decorating. Okay, so there we have it. Our mask. Our new and improved mask. So have fun, everyone. See what kind of other ideas you can come up with and let's go.
TALOFA everyone, this is going to be another way that we can get creative at home and make a face mask with only using your t-shirt. I'm going to be using my M&M t-shirt just because I like the logo on it, and when it shows up on my face it's going to look like this. Cool, so let's get into it. Alright, so what we're going to do first, we're going to put our top on like we normally would, just don't put your arms through the armholes. Just like this. Step two, we're going to pull our top up over our nose, just like this. Grab our arm sleeves, bring it to the back of our heads and tie it up. Just like that. And you can either tuck your top in, your top or your hoodie, like this. And there you have it, team. See yous.
TALOFA. Today we're going to make a mask out of a paper bag. Things we need is our paper bag, some scissors, and some colouring pens. First thing we're going to do is chop the handles off our bag, because we don't need those anymore. And then what we're going to do is we're going to draw where we're going to cut our eyes out. Be very careful with the scissors. And then we can design our mask. You can draw whatever you want on it. Some eyebrows. Now our mask is ready.
TALOFA Lava. This week I'll be making two masks. Mask one. Cut around the eyes.
stick the mouth on and put in the hair. Let's see how that looks. We are doing mask two. Draw around the outside. Then paint all of this black. Like so. Cut the circle out. Pop this through. And glue your stuff on. And there you have it all glued. Now let's jump in it.
So that brings us to the end of this week's episode of Tamariki Ma. Hopefully you learned a few more tips about keeping ourselves healthy and also had some fun with arts and crafts, making sure we're showing resilience or taikaha throughout. Time for us to sign off. Remember, our greeting today came from Samoa, which means our farewell does too, and how they say goodbye in Samoa, they say tofa. So from all of us here at Kiwi Can, we say tofa, Tamariki Ma.